Thank you, Professor Hunziker, for the introduction. And I also want to thank the organizer, the Scientific Committee, for selecting our work to be presented in this session. And I must say that I will present the results obtained in Euronanomed project, and this is a small part of this result. And this Euronanomed project called NanoTheater. In this project is are involved seven partners for four countries from Romania, Germany, Switzerland, and Turkey. Despite the outstanding progress in developing new technologies for diagnosis and new therapeutics, cardiovascular diseases remain the leading cause of morbidity and mortality in the whole world. Cardiovascular disease refer to any disease that affect cardiovascular system, heart or blood vessels. The pathological conditions that underline the cardiovascular artery disease or acute myocardial infarction or stroke or peripheral artery disease is atherosclerotic plaque formation. As previous speakers presented here, atherosclerosis is an inflammatory disease which is characterized by an inflammatory process and the specific repertoire of chemokines and cell adhesion molecules that attract particular immune cells into the plaque. Chemokines are small, highly specialized polypeptides that function as regulators of cellular traffic through their interaction with G-protein coupled receptors. They are expressed on glycosaminoglycans on the surface of endothelial cells and guide the leukocyte entry into the arterial wall. Since chemokines are critically involved in the atherosclerosis development, we thought that an interference in the interaction between chemokine and chemokine receptors will determine the inhibition of transmigration of monocyte into arterial wall. So our working hypothesis was the following. Nanoparticles targeting exclusively activated endothelium will carry chemokine receptor antagonist, and upon binding, nanoparticles will release the antagonist, thus blocking downstream the inflammatory process and prevent the atheroma development. We choose this approach because the systemic intervention in chemokine system revealed detrimental immunologic effects. So we aim to develop a targeted delivery of chemokine inhibitors at the surface of endothelial cells in order to prevent the monocyte infiltration. In order to develop a liposomal carrier system able to interfere with the chemokine network at the surface of activated endothelial cells, nanocarrier system should efficiently entrap chemokine receptor antagonist, should display a specific target accumulation at the surface of endothelial cells, and should release the cargo content at the surface before cellular uptake of the carrier. And choose the target-sensitive liposomes, and we try to combine the vascular targetability with the trigger release at the endothelial surface, and use the principle of target-sensitive liposomes described by Li Huang, and we adapt the pegylation in order to increase the circulation in the blood. Target-sensitive liposomes, or TCL, have a balanced lipid composition. By mixing the DOPE, dioleoyl phosphatidyl ethanolamine, which is a phospholipid that alone cannot form bilayers, form inverted micelles, and this DOPE is stabilized in the bilayers by charged phospholipids, such as DOPA. diol phosphatidic acid and lipid anchor that will be used to couple the homing devices. We optimize the lipid composition of TCL in order to make a compromise between target stability and target recognition and the stability of liposomes, and we varied the composition of DOPE and also the concentration of PEG into bilayers. And for vascular targeting, we used the VCAM1 as one of the most promising targets expressed on the surface of endothelial cells in inflammatory conditions. This molecule, the vascular cell adhesion molecule 1, is expressed on cultured endothelial cell surface and also is expressed on the surface of endothelial cells that cover the developing atheroma plaque. And we coupled at the surface of liposomes a peptide which was obtained by in vivo phage display by Kelly. And we coupled this peptide at the surface of liposome via a thioether bond, between cysteine from the peptide and malamide from the on the liposome surface. And we characterized these liposomes, and the size was around 150 nanometers. And also we determined the amount of peptide coupled at the surface of liposomes. The entrapment stability was also determined for different composition of TSL, and we investigated the storage, stability at 4 degrees by using different concentration of DOPA in the bilayer and 5 mol% PEG. And we could observe that the best stability is obtained with the formulation of liposomes containing 35 mol% DOPE in the bilayer in comparison with the formulation that contain 10 mol% DOP that after 50 days release 95%, whereas in the case of 35% DOPA in the bilayer, only 10% was released. And also this lipid composition was the best for stability studies at 37 degrees. Because a certain percent of PEG is needed in order to avoid the interaction with serum components and obtain a system with high stability in the blood. On the other hand, the presence of PEG on the surface could antagonize the triggered release mechanism. We also investigated the effect of PEG in the membrane, and we have done the calcium release studies in the 20% serum or 50% serum, and the best results were obtained with the liposomes, target-sensitive liposomes, with a composition of 60 mol% DOPE, 35 DOPA, and altogether 5 mol% PEG. And this composition was used for further studies to determine the functional role of these liposomes. Also investigated the targeting potential in vitro, and we could obtain that non-targeted liposomes TSL bind to activated endothelial cells very low, and the binding of targeted TSL to activated endothelial cells is significantly increased in comparison with binding to non-activated endothelial cells. And specific binding of targeted VCAM1 targeted liposomes, which can be seen also here in fluorescence microscopy imaging, is completely blocked when the liposomes are pre-incubated with the soluble VCAM1 before incubation with endothelial cells. Also, we perform release studies using calcium-loaded liposomes, and we compare the release from sensitive liposomes containing DOP and DOPA and non-sensitive conventional liposomes containing phosphatidylcholine cholesterol. And we obtained that targeted target-sensitive liposomes release the highest quantity of calcium in comparison with non-sensitive liposomes. In atherosclerosis, there are three main chemokine receptor axes involved, namely MCP1, or CCL2 and CCR2, CCL5, CCR5, and fractalkine receptors, CX3, CR1. And CCR2 is expressed on the surface of endothelial cells and also on the monocytes. And the delivery of the CCR2 antagonist will interfere in the interaction of monocytes with activated endothelial cells by blocking CCR2 either on monocytes and on endothelial cells. We selected for entrapment into the liposomes Teijin compound 1, which is water soluble, and these characteristics should assure a comparable release as we obtain for calcium. And we encapsulated this compound into the liposomes, into the sensitive and non-sensitive liposomes, and we detected by HPLC the amount of Teijin loaded. Also, we determined the CCR2 antagonist release from TCL after interaction with activated endothelial cells, and we determined the percent of Teijin release at the surface of activated endothelial cells, and we could observe that target TCL present the highest Teijin release that has value of 45 after 1 hour and reach 65% after 6 hours, whereas the best values for non-targeted TCL or targeted CL1 are 30, almost 30, and 8%. We studied the functional role of this CCR2 antagonist delivered by TCL on human monocyte transmigration using Boyden chamber. And we activated the endothelial cells that were cultured on the filter and then incubated with monocytes in the presence or absence of free Teijin or liposome encapsulated. And we determined the percent of inhibition in monocyte transmigration. And we could observe that targeted TSL has the maximum inhibitory effects in comparison with free Teijin or with the other type of liposomes, non-targeted or targeted non-sensitive liposomes. We checked the functionality of Teijin in a mouse model, and we followed the effect of Teijin CCR2 antagonist on RAU cell line infiltration. RAU is a monocyte macrophage mouse that express CCR2, and we incubated the RAU cells that were fluorescently labeled. We incubated with Teijin before administration in situ into the mouse aorta, and we could observe that the presence, that the incubation with Teijin decreased the monocyte accumulation infiltration in the aorta. Also, we follow the binding of liposome to the aorta of ApoE deficient and wild-type mites, C57 black. And we perform also in situ and in vivo experiments. And in both cases, we obtain a higher localization of liposomes to ApoE deficient mice aorta. And next, we follow the therapeutic effect of TGN encapsulated TSL on atherosclerosis lesion development. And we treated the mice at 7 weeks of age. We treated with different type of liposomes or free CCR2 antagonist, together with hyperlipidemic diet, 1% cholesterol and 50% butter. We use this concentration of TGN, 2.5 milligram, either free or encapsulated into a liposome per kilogram body. And we have done the treatment for six weeks, three times per week. And at the end, we examined the aortas for lipid deposits, and we have done the cytokine determination in sera. Here is the group of control, the representative aorta from the control. This is the aorta from the animal treated with targeted TSL, non-targeted TSL, and free TGN. And we could observe an inhibition, significant inhibition of 25% of targeted treated with targeted TSL. Also, we obtain an inhibition in mice treated with non-targeted TSL, but the inhibition obtained in the case of liposome-delivered antagonists was higher than in the case of free TGN. And also, we look at the effect of TGN encapsulated TSL on systemic level of cytokine chemokines using a cytokine array. And we could observe an increase in MCP1. And this result is in line with the studies that show increase in MCP1 levels after treatment with the CCR2 antagonist. And what we could also observe that that the treatment of mice with non-targeted TSL determine an increase in a change in cytokine chemokine profiles with a more pronounced effect on macrophage secreted cytokine. So in conclusion, we developed the VCAM1-directed target-sensitive liposomes carrying a CCR2 antagonist that is able to release the content after binding to the surface of activated endothelial cells, that decrease the monocyte transmigration through endothelial cells and reduce the atherosclerotic lesion after administration. And I want to thank to the team that to the ICBP team that contributed to the obtaining of these results. And I also want to acknowledge the financial support from Executive Agency of Higher Education, Research, Development, and Innovation that support this ERANET project in Romania. And also I want to thank to BEAT and CLINAM for supporting my participation to the meeting. And I want to thank you for the attention.
Thank you very much for this very comprehensive report. This is a very comprehensive study. Now, let us discuss questions first to this presentation and then also to all other presentations. Who would like to start? So one question I have is, I think you have very nice results. Now, infusing a therapy during 6 weeks to an organism will not be the long-term goal of your therapy. So do you have ideas how to translate that in a clinically applicable treatment schedule in the event that things work out, or is this rather the research focus?
Yeah, this is difficult for atherosclerosis, which is a disease that builds in time, and it's difficult to find a cure to give once and a medicine to give once and cure the atherosclerosis. So it's difficult to envisage such a treatment, because we need to treat for a long time in order to deplete the infiltration. Yeah. So I have no answer.
So maybe we should think of infusion pumps then,
infusion
like
pumps,
which for your life always infuse.
I was thinking of this, but yeah.
I mean, at some point, it anyway seems that medicine will replace all your body parts. So why not add an additional pump to all the other mechanics which you will have built in 20 years from now?
Yeah.
Any discussion points to other presentations? Yes?
Patrick, you showed this brilliant slide where you say you can do it too early and you can do it too late, but you should do it right in the middle where it's good. There's one big problem in that concept. In that particular period, these patients are not patients yet. So
yes.
We don't know who they are, and the problem is we will not get reimbursement. So, though I like your scheme, you are a very intelligent man. How do you envision that? Can we ever reach that? Because the majority of those subjects are walking on the street outside.
Now, you saw that word in the asymptomatic moderate risk population. And this has a background, because there are means to identify moderate risk patients. And I happen to have published in the non-nano field some years ago a study looking at advanced ultrasonic methods to assess risk in such patients based on aortic mechanics. And I think we are really at the stage now where we have some methods to kind of screen the general population with non-invasive methods for this moderate risk group. Now, if this will mean a widespread therapy or not, I cannot say. For the health insurance, I completely agree that today they would not pay such a management. If you look at the cost incurred by atherosclerosis to society, even an expensive treatment in an asymptomatic, say, spend 10,000 for a single treatment, or 20,000 or 30,000 for a single treatment, if this cures your atherosclerosis for 10 to 15 years, this would be highly cost effective. So I think one reason of this Clinom conference is not only to learn about technical details, but also to connect to the politicians and the regulatory agencies, because it's them who will collaborate with us to shape this new way of thinking. So I believe, yes, today they will health insurance will not pay. If I would be the owner of a large company with 10,000 employees, and I would be asked, do you want to avoid any myocardial infarction and stroke in your employees, and they would just do the financial accounting, I might be inclined to pay it, because it may be cheaper for me as a company to pay the treatment than to wait until these myocardial infarctions in my 40, 50, 60-year-old people happen. So it's a complex question, and a very correct one. Yes?
I have not a question, just a comment for this discussion. You said one very important thing. The possible drug, the putative drug, must be with very, very low side effects. And so I want to guess that we must not forget the lesson from the glucocorticoid. The glucocorticoid activates the inflammatory process. And this brings me back a little bit to join you. Again, macrophages, monocytes are very important, but the lesson from the glucocorticoid tells us that the T-cell system is also important, because you just know that glucocorticoids may suppress, in general, also T-cell, but not so strongly activated DH1 cells. And this very active, dangerous T-cell subsets may be positively selected by the corticoid application. And so this would work better with the recombinant HDL, with the statin. It may really be interesting because it acts not in that way. And also possibly you mentioned the liver, because the liver is really important for catching the atherosclerotic process, and recombinant HDL with statin may also act in the liver in a positive manner. And so I want really build a golden bridge to the recombinant HDL with statin.